They said it was supposed to be the summer of Morbius, but they lied. Morbius didn't even get to be the worst superhero movie of the year.
It's Morbin time.
Black Adam arrives as the apotheosis of the superhero movie as empty blockbuster. The plot of the film is fairly straightforward. Explorers digging through the ruins in the ancient nation of Kandak awaken the region's millennia-old superhero, Teth Adam. This attracts the attention of the Justice Society, who are dispatched to take him into Amanda Waller's custody. Shenanigans and the third act of X-Men Apocalypse ensue, involving a MacGuffin in the form of an ancient crown that, when used correctly, can unleash the obligatory CGI-flooded third act. In some ways, Black Adam is an experiment about what happens when you strip the modern superhero movie down to its essence, removing unnecessary details like characterization, motivation, stakes, themes, or substance. It's a simulacra of a blockbuster movie, a superhero film that seems to have been reconstructed from the memory of a sugar-addled seven-year-old. One that assumes that constant action is equivalent to momentum, that stuff happening is automatically interesting stuff. Black Adam often feels like a copy of a copy of a copy. The movie makes sure to lift several images directly from the source material, but divorces them so completely from context that they become uncanny and distracting. Black Adam will often have characters strike a pose or reference the first page Google image search results for a character, only to then realize that the image doesn't fit in the movie and they probably shouldn't have included it at all. Indeed, director Juan Colesera, who did impressive genre work on movies like The Shallows and The Commuter, just borrows the superhero movie starter pack. Black Adam runs only 2 hours, but would clock in at about 90 minutes if you stripped out all the slow motion. Lifting a page directly from first year graphic design, the film is saturated with blues and golds, but has no distinctive visual identity. Indeed, the effect is a movie that often feels like an empty parody of director Zack Snyder's style. Because at least Snyder isn't offering an unconvincing imitation of himself. We're talking a lot about the surface elements of Black Adam because, well, that's all there is. The writing is lazy and generic. To humanize the title character, the movie gives him an adorable kid companion who has an attitude, a superhero fandom, and a skateboard. It's tempting to describe the movie as tonally inconsistent, but that would imply that it has a tone at all, instead of bouncing idly from jokes about lunchboxes to melancholy meditations on immortality. Black Adam constantly stops dead in its tracks to offer blunt exposition dumps of backstory, as if characters are caught in a live-action editing war on Wikipedia. There are lots of flashbacks, technobabble, comic book continuity references, objects that have the rough shape of jokes, and clumsy attempts at catchphrases.
And as the man in black himself would say, toodaloo, motherfucker.
But there is no substance underpinning this. This is a movie that never even bothers to explain what the Justice Society actually is, compared to, say, the Justice League. It doesn't explain what Carter Hall's deal is, or why he's taking two untested kids on a life-threatening mission, or why he has wings and brands himself as a hawk. All this is because Black Adam isn't really a movie. It's a clumsy pitch for Dwayne Johnson's desire to beat up Superman on screen, because he and Henry Cavill share the same agent, and presumably because Vin Diesel won't play with him anymore. The real Herculean effort in Black Adam is watching a movie star bend an intellectual property so effectively to his will. Even Colesera is working on Black Adam in the same way that Christopher McQuarrie, Doug Liman, or Joseph Kaczynski might be working on a Tom Cruise project. Colesera obviously has an existing creative partnership with Johnson, having recently worked with him on Jungle Cruise. To be fair, there are glimmers of a better movie buried somewhere in here. Aldous Hodge and Pierce Brosnan work surprisingly well together in the few scenes that they're given with dialogue. There's also the bones of an interesting story about interventionism in here as well. However, these are shadows and specters lost in the cacophony of chaos. To put it frankly, Black Adam isn't worth a damn. Or, to quote the man himself,
toodaloo, motherfucker!
Black Adam is releasing in cinemas on Friday, 21st October.